men and women of God, unless I keep you too long, I got one other thing I got to tell you. As we've been talking about what's in our garden, as we've been talking about the good, as we've been talking about the bad, as we've been talking about the undeveloped, as we've been talking about what needs to be removed, the last part of the text, I believe, blesses us real good. The last part of the text simply reminds us in this wise, gardening is hard work, but it's well worth the wait. Gardening is hard work, but it's well worth the wait. It's right there in verse 9 and 10. It tells us to do what? Let us not get tired of doing what is good. Let us not get tired of doing what is good. At just the right time. Can somebody say right time? Can you type in right time? At just the right time, we will reap a harvest of blessing if we don't give up. Therefore, whenever we have the opportunity, we should do good to everyone, especially those in the family of faith. Men and women of God, there are times on the journey that we feel like giving up. Amen, somebody. We wrestle with whether God's way is the best way. We saw that often in the Old Testament, where they see everybody else surviving and everybody else doing well, but the people of God seem to be struggling. I know that is not just the Old Testament. I know that is some of us ourselves. We wonder whether or not God's way is the best way. We wrestle with our struggles. We wrestle with our challenges. We wrestle with everything that is before us. But God says that in the right time, we will reap a harvest. Can I tell you a story that I discovered that blessed me and I pray blesses you? The story is told of an Indonesian farmer. His name was Pak Sadiman. Farmer Sadiman lived in Indonesia and he was on assignment. I say that he was on assignment because when I tell you his story, everybody else said it was coincidence, but we know better than that. God doesn't work in coincidence. God is always up to something. So Farmer Sadiman is on assignment as a farmer, and he's growing rubber trees. But what happened was something amazing. His town was by the Gendol River, and the water began to dry up, and the villagers were in danger of losing everything that they owned. But there was something that Sadiman discovered when he was planting his rubber trees. As he was planting his rubber trees, somehow he discovered there was a banyan tree, which was not like the rubber trees that would absorb the groundwater. The banyan tree would retain the groundwater. In other words, they could go to the banyan tree and get all of the water that they needed. Oh, when he told everybody about it, they didn't know what he was talking about, because that's what it's like when God burst something in you. He had a choice. Farmer Sadiman could have said, nobody believes me, they think I'm crazy, or he could have planted a seed. I'm here to tell you that Farmer Sadiman planted a seed. They say that over 19 years, he planted 11,000 trees. Did you hear me? It took 19 years before the water showed up, but over 19 years, he planted 11,000 seeds. I need to remind somebody, you've been planting, you've been sowing, you've been doing what God has called you to do, but you have yet to reap the harvest. Men and women of God, I pray that you are like Farmer Sadiman, that you don't give up, that you don't throw in the towel. You see, the villagers were blessed because one day they woke up and they had water. One day they woke up and their prayers had been answered. One day they woke up and the seeds had broken through. The town people said, Farmer Sadiman is our hero. He saw what nobody else saw. He planted seeds when nobody else was planting. And because of Farmer Sadiman's faithfulness, my children can eat. My mama can eat. I'm here to remind somebody that if you are faithful in planting seeds and don't give up and don't go in the towel, everybody around you will be blessed. I am so glad that God lives by this life principle. I am so glad Jesus was a seed that was planted in a borrowed tomb. I am so glad they thought burying the seed would kill the seed. But what they meant for evil, God meant for good. God used what was buried, and on the third day morning, the seed broke through. On the third day morning, the seed got up. On the third day morning, we started walking in new power. That's why I worship the way I worship, because the seed broke through. It's a reminder that if he broke through, breakthrough is available for me. It's a reminder that if he was buried, when I'm down and out, God is up to something. Shout out to everybody. You've been down and out, but you knew God was up to something. They didn't think you would get out. They thought it was over, but breaking you just allowed a new seed to come out. That's why I worship the way I worship. I've been through too much not to worship him. Do you hear what I said? I've been through too much not to worship him. I've had too many setbacks, but he made a way. I didn't have what I needed, but he provided for me. I've been through too much not to worship him. Is that your story? Why don't you give him some praise? Look to your left. Look to your right. Look in your family album. You've been through too much not to worship him. You've been through too much not to worship him. But when I think about Jesus and all he's done for me, I've been through too much not to worship him. Let's celebrate God one more time. Let's celebrate God one more time. Let's celebrate God one more time. To God be the glory.